5-Minute Mysteries review. It's been a long time since I posted a fresh review up. I was freshly sent this lovely tome from my friend in Colombia, Andrew, also known as Andrew Mentalist for those who follow him on Facebook and social media. What this is Intimum Sacrarium. My other languages are not too good, but essentially what we have here is a book of, I counted 14 different effects in a very nicely produced volume. This is put together extremely well. As you can see, there's pictures inside. There's everything you really need. There's a couple things included with it just in case. And of course, my friend Andrew's luck was nice enough to send me 1,000 pesos, which is about 30 cents US. So what's in the book, essentially? I'll kind of go through briefly, step by step, what everything's in here. Most of the material in the book is AAA. For those of you who don't know what AAA means, it means anytime, anywhere. Sorry, anytime, anywhere, for anyone. There we go. Kind of a Mark Paul-inspired term there. So starting off the book, there is a lovely revelation. Let me find it. It is literally called Revelation, and it's a drawing revelation kind of based on an interesting, I want to say channeling kind of idea in a way, or a presentation for this kind of unique idea that has a great ending where there's a picture in an envelope that's predicted based on the audience's decisions. Very AAA, very interesting. Color vision is probably one of my main things. Color vision in the next one, which is called, double check here so I don't sound like an idiot, A Secret Memory. These two are the most exciting kind of pieces, in my opinion, in the book. These are things that really excite me. What Andrew's done here is taken a really old principle inspired by a certain magician that we have all heard of before. He invented a few very popular effects, and he's taken it and revamped it and turned it into something completely different. Something that's almost unrecognizable. So you show this to other mentalist magicians, I'm sure they would actually be fooled by it. A friend of mine uses the normal version of this, the original version, quite often. He still fools magicians, so this is a great old effect. His witch hand presentations in here are really interesting. You can tell Andrew's really big into his witch hand plots. In A Handful of Miracles, for example, it's kind of an interesting take on fusing this kind of matchbook divination idea with a few other different ideas that's produced a really nice effect that can, but in my opinion, it sounds like it can be done even over the phone in some of the examples presented in the book. Many interesting variations on are taught, so they're depending on your style, your presentation, what you're going to do, you can, you know, change up the presentation to make it more or less AAA as kind of the front, at the forefront of the review here. Hail Nostrum, another amazing witch hand plot, has some other different elements to it. It's kind of like a small act in a way, built together into one with one centralized presentation. Very interesting things. The fortune teller, it's an incredible little piece. It's the key thing about this book is there's nothing in here that's overly complicated. There's nothing that I think is too hard for people to follow. It's all really well done. There's utility devices such as Insight in here, which he has a presentation for, of course, as well. But the inside envelope gives you the ability to have somebody seal a billet into an envelope, and you can still read that thought very, very easily. And it's a kind of a one-time build you'll have for the rest of your life. I think some inside is one of those things, either you're going to love it or hate it, I feel like. I personally think it's a very clever idea, and I like where it's coming from. Very interesting ideas, the ESP cards in your fantastic presentations, where it really is a nice hands-off feeling routine, but depending on how you present it and how you take it about. Now we get into some of the contributions here. The Cold de Grail, I'm sorry, I will show your name, sir, but I cannot pronounce it. I'm going to go with Niels. By Niels is a wonderful piece. It's just kind of a structure for one of the true great effects in mentalism, invented by John Cornelius. But the presentation also can apply to billets, such like that. But it's just a brilliant idea and a brilliant presentation. Steve Drury, of course, gives a nice charming little effect in here with his efflorescence, which is a lovely little bit. And if you know me, I love ideas where you can give a memorable souvenir, even if it's not just really an effect. You're not doing something where apparently predicting or reading somebody's mind per se, which this does have it. This routine does have in it, but more than anything, it's about this nice giving of a gift to the spectator at the end. It's a charming little gift. I'm probably gonna learn how to make this just so it is available as a secret to me to pull out. I enjoy these kind of things. There's reading systems taught in there as well that go with the original routine. Essentially, there's some other nice contributions here from Primo, Blast Chang. Yes. Nice tarot card effects in here. Cedric Taylor has a wonderful idea of prophecy in here with a deck of cards. Christopher Taylor, of course, always amazing when he contributes with his being there effect, which, once again, it's for the most part made everything's here AAA, but there are some things included with it, such as the cards that are pre-printed so you can easily and effectively do Christopher Taylor's effect as well in there. Overall, the production value is the real highlight of this book. It's just beautifully produced. It's really nice. I know, for those of you that have never... Oh, this is a cool images in between and such. For those of you that are not familiar with the publishing side of things, especially in different countries, luckily I've been privileged to meet a lot of people from different countries that do publish books. The high price tag on these books sometimes is not just because of the secrets themselves, because of the production value. I'm sure that our friend Andrew is not making quite as much on this book as you would think he is, selling it at the price tag he is. So, if you really want to support an excellent artist's work, you know, don't think that you're basically paying just for the secrets. To understand the book production costs quite a lot as well. Overall, I recommend this volume quite a lot. Andrew's a very creative thinker. He's able to take kind of some of these older ideas too. I've noticed that in the writing inside of this book. His style's very nice, feels conversational. And he definitely digs deep into the older stuff to pull out some fresh ideas and fresh applications. Like I said, the color vision and a secret memory routine are really, really great in this book. And it's been a real honor to be able to be one of the first people to see and have this in their hands so I can, you know, tell the world about exactly what this is, because he spent years on this. So, overall, really recommended, excellent book. I know we've gone over the normal time a little bit, but I wanted to make sure we went through in depth, and so you know what you're getting in a book such as this. $150 and $150, is it a high price tag? Yes. But does it cost a lot to produce this book and take the time, the love, the editing, the graphic design that goes into it, as well as the thinking itself of effects? Yeah, if you want to read this book and have the material in it, which is some very nice AAA material, then you are going to be needing to pay the $150. This is the $150 copy right here. I always like to go big when I go with books. Beautifully produced, as you can see. Very nice lettering on the front. Very well put together. First thing I said to Andrew when I got this in the mail from him, he was kind enough to speed deliver it to me, being the kind gent that he is. I was so impressed by the overall production value of it alone before I even got into the effects themselves. So please do check this out. You'll see the link below here where you can find out more information on it. Secure your copy today and enjoy having some nice AAA mysteries in your back pocket. I should also mention, we're signing off here, this is not all propless stuff. You know I'm a big fan of the propless components. I've reviewed a lot of them on here, and there's going to be another one following this of a book on propless mentalism by my friend Ross Taylor. This is not really propless mentalism. It still has props, it still has surefire methods. There are a few risky bits in here, but nothing that you couldn't, you know, for social situations as well as for paid performances, use. So please do invest in some of this quality work props to you, Andrew. It's absolutely wonderfully produced. Thank you all for watching. I'll see you next time.